Hey everybody, Sean and Allison here from Spoken Garden. Today it's Plant Chat Friday, and so we're going to talk to you today about Christmas cactus.
Which is an indoor plant, right? That's why we're inside.
That's why we're inside. You might be looking behind us going, what are you guys doing inside?
So before we get to all that though, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below so you don't miss out on every daily video. This whole month, if you haven't caught it yet, we are actually featuring holiday plants. So last week we were outside and we got to show you our beautiful Christmas rose hellebore. So again, this week we're indoors with our indoor plant. We are gonna show you our Christmas cactus. Look how beautiful this little plant is. Isn't that pretty? These beautiful, delicate flowers that come in red and kind of a magenta color almost. They kind of are turning different colors as they bloom. And you can see here, it's definitely a succulent. It's kind of got that cactus look, and it's actually hardy to zones 11 and 12. So it's usually sold as an indoor plant. And this time of year is perfect because it's in bloom, and again, it's called the Christmas cactus.
So guys, like Allison was telling you, this is the Christmas cactus, and it's actually a true cactus. It's pretty cool. It's in the Cactaceae family. This little guy can get anywhere from 6 inches to over 2 feet tall, depending on which hybrid you get and you know, which cultivar it is. So now the Latin name is Schlumbergera X Bucklii, and the X is because it's a hybrid. So yeah, this is a neat little plant. It grows upright as you see it right here, and then it kind of undulates and kind of flows over and kind of bows down as it gets bigger and larger. And so it's made up of these little leaves, they're little sections, and it grows from the tip top part right here. It'll get a, you see where that that flower bud is right there? When it's done flowering here, there's actually little buds on the sides here, and that'll grow another one of these leaves eventually, and it just keeps growing a leaf at a time. It's pretty cool. So this plant will flower starting around Christmas. This was forced to flower before we got it. This is our first Christmas cactus, but I grew up with these. So these are really easy to take care of. It'll flower though from around Christmas all the way into mid-winter. And so that's pretty cool, right? It's a long blooming indoor plant, really neat. Now it is a cactus, so it is very drought tolerant. You need to treat it like a cactus. It does need well-draining soil. It needs indirect full sunlight. And so you're like, what does that mean? Indirect full sunlight? Why not just full sunlight? Well, it doesn't need full sunlight, intense sunlight on it. It just needs indirect. So indirect sunlight means it needs to be close to the window, but it needs to be out of the direct sunlight coming through the window. So just over that barrier or that threshold of full sun shade inside your house, if that makes sense. If not, let us know down in the comments down below and we'll talk more about it. So guys, having these plants indoors, you wanna give them their optimal care, because if you don't, they're gonna get stressed and then they're basically gonna be more susceptible to spider mites. They're gonna be susceptible to scale and aphids and even mealybugs. And those are nasty pests, especially to have indoors in a confined space, because if they get on one plant, they can then go to your other plants.
Okay, you guys, it is, as far as like companion planting, you're probably used to Sean and I talking about that with all our outdoor plants that we usually feature. Indoor plants, especially like this one, it's common to usually just keep it in its own pot, separate from other plants. It doesn't mean you couldn't plant it together with something else, but you would want to make sure that the other plants have the same needs as far as sunlight, like indirect sunlight, like Sean was explaining. So some companion planting ideas for indoor plants could be mother-in-law's tongue or maybe spider plant. Those have similar care needs and have similar light needs and all of that stuff. So you could place them in pots around, you know, this Christmas cactus. That's what we would recommend, is keep it in its own pot. So that's the Christmas cactus, you guys. It's a great holiday plant because it blooms around Christmas time and it blooms into the winter.
Yeah, we hope you enjoyed our indoor plant chat today, this Friday. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below for us. We love hearing from you. Give us that thumbs up, let us know we're doing a good job, and subscribe to our channel so you get updates on our latest videos.
And we'll be back tomorrow with our next garden care video, probably outside. We hope you have a great day ahead. See you tomorrow, everybody.
Have a great day, everybody.